Diodes have a number of ratings or specifications. Careful attention has to be given to diode ratings before designing a practical application circuit. Let us look at some important ratings of diode that apply to all types of diodes and applications. Few of the diode ratings are forward voltage drop, maximum forward current, reverse saturation current, reverse voltage, maximum power dissipation. Let us see in detail about these specifications. The forward voltage drop is a forward conducting junction voltage or the barrier potential. It is 0.3 volt for germanium and 0.7 volt for silicon. The actual voltage drop depends on the diode type and the current flowing through the diode also. Average forward current is a maximum current of forward conduction that the diode can carry for an infinite period of time. If the average current exceeds its value, the diode will overheat and eventually destroy itself. Next is peak reverse voltage or peak repetitive reverse voltage or peak inverse voltage. This is the largest amount of reverse bias voltage the diode junction can withstand without damaging the junction. If voltage exceeds this value, junction breakdown occurs, which usually destroys the diode. Next is forward power dissipation. The actual power dissipation is calculated by multiplying the forward voltage and the forward current. So this must be less than the maximum power dissipation rating of the diode. Exceeding the maximum value will result in catastrophic effects. Excessive forward current and excessive reverse breakdown voltage are the most common causes of diode failure. In both cases, diode gets very hot and this heat destroys the PN junction. To prevent this from occurring, diodes are selected for an application circuit with ratings at least two times the expected or designed values of that circuit. Now, how to choose a suitable diode for a particular application? From where these specifications or ratings of diode can be obtained. The specifications of any device is provided by the device manufacturer in the form of data sheets. So let us have a look at a couple of data sheets and you will learn about how to read the data sheets. So a portion of typical data sheet is shown here from Fairchild Semiconductor Corporation, and another data sheet from ON Semiconductor is shown here. If you look at these two data sheets, most of the data sheet starts with the device type number at the top of the page here, such as 1N4001 to 1N4007. And here in this data sheet, it is also 1N4001 to 1N4007. So the part number is same respective of the manufacturer. Now here in this part number, the 1N type number signifies a single junction device, that is a diode. Next, after this, a short description title follows this type number. So you can find general purpose rectifiers here, or a standard recovery rectifiers, and even here it shows general purpose low power applications. Sometimes mechanical data is also shown, usually in the form of an illustration like this. Or it will show you the package type and dimensions like this. So you can find the dimensions here, the type of the package. It is shown as lead plastic, axial lead plastic. Okay. Following this, you will have the maximum ratings of the diode. The maximum ratings are the maximum voltages and currents that can be applied without destroying the device. Let us have a look at the maximum ratings alone. So you can see here the peak repetitive reverse voltage is around 50 volts for 1N4001 diode, and for a 1N4007 diode it is around 1000 volts. So this is the maximum value of the reverse voltage that the diode can withstand without damaging it. A list of other electrical characteristics also follows the maximum ratings. Like you can see the forward voltage, like it is 1.1 volt, maximum forward voltage is 1.1 volt for this particular diode, and reverse current, So all the electrical characteristics is also listed here. So if you frequently read the data sheet, you will become familiar with all the parameters. So you can see the same parameters from different data sheet of ON semiconductors. So you can see the maximum ratings followed by the electrical characteristics. Next, let us look at diode testing. Diode testing is done to determine the condition of semiconductor diode, whether it is functional or not. Every digital multimeter has a diode checking capability like this, a diode symbol. Set the meter in this position and the positive terminal of your multimeter or the red color probe is connected to the anode and negative to the cathode, that is black color probe to the cathode. The display will indicate the diode forward voltage. So you can see here, it displays 0.601 volts. So if the diode forward voltage is displayed, then this indicates that the diode is functional. And you have to verify this, the reverse condition also. So when reverse connected, that is when red color is connected to cathode and black color probe is connected to the anode, the functioning diode produces a OL or a 0L display. This OL or a 0L indicates a high resistance. As you know that in reverse bias condition, the diode offers a very high resistance, almost it's open circuited. So this OL or 0L indicates open circuited diode. So in the forward condition, it should show the forward diode forward voltage, and in the reverse condition, it should show a high resistance or an OL display. Then you can say that the diode is a good diode or a functional diode. Now, if the OL display occurs with both forward as well as reverse conditions, then the diode is a defective diode. So in this case, it is a bad diode. It is not a good diode. There are different types of diodes or different packages of junction diodes are available for different applications in electronic circuits. Like the one which is shown here is a general purpose diode, and you have power diode also. So this is a power diode, and power diode with stud mounted. So stud mounted power diodes. This is capable of handling higher currents. And to be more convenient to be used in PCBs, you have flat chip surface mount devices or diodes also. So these type of devices you might have seen in PCBs, miniature PCBs, such type of PCBs. Thank you.